Making your way in the world today takes everything you got. Hidden away from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name. Bum, 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 bum. And they're always glad you came. Bum, bum, bum. You wanna go where people know troubles are all the same. You wanna go where everybody knows your name. That's why I got you guys. Hi kids, it's Granny. Welcome to just another Monday. Oh, Mondays are kind of a drag. I don't know, it's like always something scheduled. And I always stay up. Ew, I spit on my steering wheel. That's gross. I always stay up too late on Saturday and Sunday nights. Actually, I stay up too late every night. And then Monday morning comes and there's always something. I gotta get up at 8 or 9 in the morning. I know, I know, I know. 8 or 9 in the morning is not early. It is to me. I'm not a morning person, you guys. I am really not a morning person. Yay. It's raining. It's a rainy freaking Monday. Yuck. Thank you for the day, Lord. Thank you for the day. Thank you for the rain. Thank you for the trees. Thank you that I can drive. Thank you that the truck has gas. Thank you that my dog's surgery went well. Thank you that she's recovering. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for the bus that's gonna pick up that poor guy that's standing in the rain right there. Thank you for all the people that say thank you. Thank you for all the people that don't say thank you. Thank you for our children and grandparents and pets and friends and family. Thank you for moms and dads and babies. It's a good world. I'm still having my moods. I had quite a mood this morning. I had to take Maya to get the drain taken out of her surgery. She had like this tube running right through her body that was supposed to help the fluid drain out of it. And they took that out today. It seemed to not be too painful to get it taken out. Poor thing. I just held onto her head and they snipped the little stitches that were holding it in and just pulled it out. Her stitches, her main stitches are still in. They had an extra couple of stitches to hold the tube in. Tube's gone. She's still got, I don't know, probably 40 stitches along there that they'll come out in about a week. So what are you doing today? What's on your agenda? You got shopping to do, people to see, places to go? What's going on? I want to know. I want to know about you. I want to know about you. I want to know about you and you and you. And I want to know about you. You. You, you, you. Here's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold like their mother, the youngest one in curls. Here's the story of a man named Brady, who was busy with three boys of his own. They were four men living all together, yet they were all alone. Till the one day when the lady met this fellow, and they knew that it was much more than a hunch, that this group must somehow form a family. That's the way we all became the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch, do do do. The Brady Bunch, do do do. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch. Do 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 do. I know you know that. I know you were singing along with me. Tell me you weren't. Let me tell y'all the story about a man named Jed. A poor mountaineer barely kept his family fed. Then one day he was sitting towards searching up some food. Went up through the ground, come a bubbling crude. Oil, that is. Black gold. Texas tea. Well, next thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire. His kinfolk said, Jed, move away from there. Said California is the place you ought to be. So they loaded up the truck and they moved to Beverly Hills, that is. Swimming pools, movie stars. The Beverly Hillbillies. That was banjo at the end there. I've about had enough of this rain. Hey, Louie, can we get a little less rain down here? As in, my husband calls God Louie. I don't know where he came up with that. Hey, Louie, it's a little wet down here. Oh no, I'm driving the wrong freaking way. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I'm so retarded. Now what am I gonna do? Am I gonna turn around? Oh my gosh. Oh, see, that's what I get for singing and carrying on. Missed my freaking turn. Long time ago. Like a long time ago. I missed it like 6 miles ago. Having a mood again. I don't want a mood. Oh my gosh. Why can't things go smoothly for me? They never go smoothly because my brain doesn't work right. You can be 57 years old and if you have ADD, it's gonna be there your whole darn life. I mean, if I have a conversation, forget about trying to get anything done. Some people, they get on the phone and they can, like, you know, clean their counters and do their dusting and freaking reorganize a cabinet all while they're on the phone. No way could I do that. No way could I do that. No, you can have the best brain in the world and if it doesn't work, then you might as well be totally stupid. What good is a great brain that doesn't work? At that point, it's not a great brain, is it? I really do live in a beautiful place. Sometimes I forget to, like, look around me. But if I look around me, I forget something. Any of you guys struggle with ADD or ADHD? Nice, I wish somebody had diagnosed it when I was a child so I could have gotten some more help in school. They just said I was distractible. She's distractible. She draws pictures. She writes notes to her friends. She talks in class. Nobody ever said, hey, she's got a great brain, but it's broken. Nobody said, hey, she's a smart kid, but she's got a problem. So you guys, I didn't put a lot of effort into looking pretty today. Not much at all. I got my tomboy thing going on today for sure. Got my camo. I'm ready for battle. Oh, Canada, my home and native land. I don't know the words, but beside you now I stand. Oh, Canada, I like you more than here. Ooh, a crab feed. There's gonna be a crab feed. Ooh, that would be fun to go to. I love a good crab feed. It's so weird. It's like I see all these local events and I want to go to them so bad. But it's weird going alone. All my close friends live so far away We can't just like say, hey, you want to do this today or you want to do that today and go do it. I don't know. I'm not used to, my husband's been disabled for 10 years and I'm still not used to doing things by myself. It's weird to me. Like when I go and do things, I like to say anything, I like to be with somebody else so that I can talk to them about it. Say, hey, what do you think of this? Or, ooh, look at that. Isn't this cool? And it's just weird when you're by yourself. I don't know, you guys. I think I'm going to call the VA, Veterans Administration, and talk to a social worker there. Because I am not able to motivate my husband. Guy showers like every 3 or 4 months. Forget sex, it ain't happening. Oh, I don't know what to do with him. I've tried and tried to motivate him. I've even used those dreaded words, you know, this isn't gonna work. Those are like words that I don't like saying. This isn't gonna work. Because it's kind of like an ultimatum. And once you give somebody an ultimatum, you kind of have to follow through or you look like a damn fool. You know, he'll nod and smile and act like he hears me, but then nothing changes. He gets up the next morning, he turns on his video game, and there he sits for the rest of the day. I mean, occasionally he'll get up and he'll do some dishes. Occasionally he gets up and he'll make himself sandwiches or hamburgers. That's it. Oh, he takes out the garbage. Once a week he takes out the garbage. But, you know, that's a pretty big deal for him. And I get that. You know, I don't care if he doesn't want to do anything physical. But he's got to get some kind of exercise. He's got to, you know, do some stretches. He's got to eat right. He won't eat vegetables. I could cook them for him. He won't eat them. So I was like, what's the point? I feel so defeated. He's a problem child. It wasn't until he hurt his back that he just decided to go to bed. And he did get a substantial back injury. I've seen the x-rays. But he just quit. He just quit. You know, he quit work, and I expected, you know, a long recovery period. I expected physical therapy and expected to make his meals for him for a while. But after 5 years of that, him not going to physical therapy, where am I going? I need to go straight. I'm sorry. Refusing to go to physical therapy, he went one time. He didn't particularly like the advice that the doctor gave him, and he didn't go back. He'll go to his doctor, he nods and he smiles, and he goes home and does exactly what he damn well pleases. Plays video games and sits in the bed. He's not living life. That's what bothers me. When you love somebody, you want them to have a life. And to live it and enjoy it and enjoy the things that it has to offer, not just one thing. Yeah, video games are fun, video games are great, but to make that your whole life, I think, is just the saddest freaking thing in the world. It's not okay, you guys. It's not okay. And that's his right. He has every right to sit in that bed for the rest of his life if he wants to. I just wish he didn't want to. How you feeling, Leslie? You tired? Something I can do for you? Here, let me get that. I love you. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm just frustrated. Wow, the color of this car I parked next to. Look at that color. Oh, what a cute little dog. You gotta see this, you guys. It's so cute. Can you see him? You see the little guy? He's adorable. Little button face.
Little button eyes. Aw, he's waiting for somebody.
Okay, I'll see you in just a couple minutes. You guys, I pulled into this parking place and I have to pee so bad I'm afraid to get out of the car. Have you ever felt like that? Like, if I stand up, it's not going to be good. Okay, I just have
I'm
to look this
I'm here in the beautiful little town of Sebastopol, and I found a thrift store. And I want to get Maya some t-shirts. Because the vet suggested to put t-shirts on her to kind of keep her wound clean. And so I'm going to do that. Get her some t-shirts at the thrift store. Yay. Support Sutter Health Hospice.
So I went to the thrift store, I got Maya some t-shirts, and I actually found a couple of tops for me. $2 a piece. How cool is that? Yay! And I got some power steering stop leak for the truck. And now I'm going home. We can have our own little cheers, you guys. We can have the mailman and the playboy and who is the other people? The psychiatrist and the floozy and the dumb girl. How come there's one floozy and one dumb girl? How come the girls never get the intellectual parts? The only two women on Cheers were a floozy and a dumb girl. What the heck? But then they made the floozy become the manager. I bet it was a bunch of letters from women about that show. I bet that's why they changed it and made her a manager. How's what's her name that does the Weight Watchers commercials? I always forget people's names. What was her name? What's her name, you guys? What was her name? What was her name? I can't think of it. Kirstie Alley. That was it. Flipper. Flipper. Faster than lightning. No one you see is smarter than he. And we know Flipper lives in a world full of wonder. Flying there Flipper. I can do Flipper. So sometimes people who work in stores don't know their products. I went in the auto parts store and I said, my husband sent me to get some stuff. It's power steering fluid, but it specifically says stop leak on it. I said, I don't know what it is, but that's what he said to get. So this woman starts walking me up and down the aisles, and she gets me to one part, and she's just like looking. She's looking and looking, and the only thing in front of her was transmission fluid. Many, many different kinds of transmission fluid. And I said to her, I said, this looks like it's all transmission fluid. I don't see power steering on any of these bottles. And she goes, yeah, well, this is where it would be. No, we found it like two aisles away. I found it. I just looked at this bottle, it just jumped out at me and said, power steering, stop leak. And I said, dude, that's it. That's the stuff. That's what I need right there. And she goes, oh, I didn't know we had anything like that. Surprise. Maybe this truck will stop leaking power steering fluid. Because we've been putting that stuff in like every week. And if we don't, it starts making this really horrible noise when you go around curves. It goes... It's exactly how it goes. It's a good day. Hope you're having a good day. Letty, I hope you're curled up in front of your fireplace. Maybe a nice glass of wine and a nice blanket and your three dogs. Andy, I hope you're just doing everything that you want to do today. You're just always out there doing something. I hope you've got nice weather to go out and do it in. And I hope your dogs are happy today, and you're happy today, and that you're feeling good. And music, I hope you're having a wonderful birthday month. We're going to be celebrating all month long with you. And yeah, I think you're awesome. I think all of you are
awesome.
Yeah,
the other day when I was backing in here and I accidentally recorded my temper tantrum, I told my husband, I said, oh my gosh, I had my camera running and I was just cussing a blue streak. He says, you can't put that on YouTube. You're a church lady. That's not right. You can't do that. You know, it's freaking real, okay? It's like, why do we want to be phony because of God? Like, God is the most unphony thing ever. Why would he want us to be phony? I think God wants us, above all, I think God wants us to feel. I think that's the whole reason that we're here, is to feel. And if you don't feel and you don't express, you're not alive. That's what I say. It's too dark in this car to film anymore. Film? Am I filming? No, I'm not. I'm videotaping. I'm hip. I'm hip. I know the terminology. Let's go inside. What a good girl. Mama loves you. I think you look very nice in your cone. What, Maya, do you want to go outside? Is that what's going on? You want to go outside? Okay.
I'm chilling.
It's going to be a relaxing afternoon. I forgot to go to the store. I totally did. I just started yakking to the cell phone, yakking on the video, forgot all about stopping and getting groceries. So I'm having soup for dinner, and that's okay. Everything's okay. I hope you guys have the most freaking fabulous evening. Love one another. Be good to one another, and love you guys. Be good to each other. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.
This is how we drink water. This is how we rock a pink t-shirt. We are rocking a pink t-shirt. Wow, you thirsty girl.
Hi, Maya.
Hi, how you doing? How's the weather in there?
How's the weather in there? Oh, I need some kisses.
Oh, I just love you.